10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go!
Now it's the Mercedes in the Morning pre-show. Woo-hoo! Mix 94.1.
Hey, good morning and welcome to the pre-show. We are at Thursday, right before us. Labor Day weekend. Want to say hello to all you checking in this morning, texting us at 702-364-9400. Rick and Sarah, Megan, Aubrey, Dean, Louie, Sandel, Dahlia is listening this morning. So is Leanna, Miss Kit Kat, Francis, and Melissa. Also checking in on Twitter at Mercedes in the AM. We have Melody, Samantha, Nisha, Kenia, all listening this morning. Thank you so much. Good morning.
How are you? I know Thanksgiving is always, Thanksgiving is the third Thursday of November. Is Labor Day always just the first Monday of September? Is that how Labor Day works?
Yeah, it's okay. Always the first Monday of September on that one.
It just seems, early this year.
Everything seems early this year, doesn't it? It's just crazy how everything is sneaking up on us. We're already back in school, what, 2-3 weeks in already?
And yes.
Then Labor Day is this weekend. And then, yeah, before you know it, we're going to be right in the midst of Christmas season. I felt like it yesterday when we played a Christmas song on this show.
It's so funny the things that people react to, because we'll sit here and plan something to, this will be the most epic conversation, radio, whatever. We plan, and it works. And then we play a Christmas song, and that's all people, that Christmas song was great. That's all people talk about.
Yeah.
It's so funny.
I think it was something that a lot of people needed, and then there were a few that were like, okay, no. It's not time for that. Try it again. Are you okay? Are you sick? You clearing your throat. Just that morning kind of thing.
It was just laughing, having a good time. Hey, life is grand.
Usually when we're up this early, you don't really have a lot of conversations with people, so it takes a while for the voice to warm up.
You do, because I do my vocal exercises.
I don't do that.
But I do them for about maybe a minute or so driving in, and that's at 4 o'clock in the morning. And then I get here, I say good morning to Steph, and that's the extent of our conversation. And then I don't speak until I see you, so I go an hour and a half, I warm up the voice, but then it sits idle for 90 minutes.
Yeah, literally the first time I speak in the morning is when I say good morning to you guys when I get here. That's it. Unless there's some issue at home, I'll try to sing to a song on the way in, but I usually forget and just kind of zone out. But yeah, this is my warming up voice, and I'd say by 6 o'clock it'll be completely warmed up, ready to go.
I think it was a tweet you did a few weeks back, and it is so true. It's that I'm probably phrasing this wrong, but your morning mood doesn't match your evening mood when it comes to getting your car in the morning and turning that radio on.
Oh yeah,
because
yeah.
This morning I got in the car and still sleepy, 4 o'clock. Turn the radio on, and some song, right now. It's Van Halen. I'm like, whoa.
Settle down.
Turn it down, too. The volume's really loud. I'm like, who was this last night, 6 o'clock p.m., JC? Turn that down, buddy.
Yeah, it's like I was a different person last night when I turned off my car.
Yes.
That usually happens to me, especially because I wake up early on Saturdays and Sundays to go to spin, and usually we'll go out the night before and maybe have a glass of wine, so we'll come back. I'm like listening so loud, so I'll turn on the radio and it'll be like screaming, like usually some really, really hardcore rap or something.
Right, it doesn't match.
Oh, good morning, everyone.
Hello. Last night, JC, you're a little bit too loud and raucous. Let's turn it down.
You were Mr. Van Halen last night, huh?
I think I was. I think I was on a classic rock station.
Oh,
I was
wow.
on a classic rock station when I rolled into the house last night.
What's classic rock now, though? That could be something like Third Eye Blind, Matchbox 20,
We talked about that last week. Yeah, 90s.
Killers.
Yeah, 90s music is now classic rock.
So if you have a different idea of what classic rock is, it's not the same anymore.
Saddens me.
I know. Those are the good old days.
Hey, also saddens me when Jocelyn walks in the building and doesn't say hello.
Jocelyn.
I'll be honest.
I think Jocelyn has to warm up in the morning, right, Jocelyn?
Yes, and also my voice is going away. I've been clearing my throat and sneezing. So good morning. Hello,
okay,
everyone.
Good morning. Hello to you.
I'm sorry. My voice is really bugging me this morning.
It happens. I've been there before.
And then I had to tell Steph, here, I forgot to buy K-cups, so take these. That is the only conversation I had this morning.
Why are you guys buying K-cups? Are you guys drinking all the K-cups? Is that why?
We buy K-cups for us to share with everyone, and we used all of them.
Oh,
and it was my turn to buy them.
It'd be like the Maxwell house. There's plenty of them back there for you.
Thank you.
Yeah, you guys are welcome. Oh, I don't know if I have any K-cups in my drawer.
We have a secret stash.
I think
emergency
someone ate
stash.
Those or drank those.
No, Mercedes, you do. I've been using them because this week it's Jocelyn.
Jocelyn's turn to buy the K-Cups, but she keeps forgetting, so I've been using your secret stash.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. It's all right. It's communal. We're all sharing around
awesome.
Here.
Thank
all is
you.
Good. So, all right. Well, let's start the show. Time for the pre-show. You pick them. You guys get to pick the first song of the show. Do you want to hear She's a Beauty by the Tubes? A Thousand Miles by Vanessa Carlton. No, I'd walk a thousand miles if I can just see you tonight. Or do you want to hear the Thong song by Cisco? Let me see that thong. Baby, show choices. Text us or call us at 702-364-9400. You can tweet us, vote on Facebook. We'll count your votes right now and reveal the winner next on Mix 94.1.
Mercedes in the Morning's What's Trending on Mix 94.1.
Jesse Combs is trending this morning. The former Mythbusters and Overhaulin' host and also the fastest woman on four wheels has died in a jet car crash. She was attempting to break her own speed record. Her teammate, Terry Madden, confirmed the news on Instagram yesterday. He said, "She was the most amazing spirit that I have ever or will ever know. Unfortunately, we lost her yesterday in a horrific accident. I was the first one there, and trust me, we did everything humanly possible to save her. She was only 36 years old."
I follow a lot of car people on Instagram, and that was just, as soon as that news broke, just all over my feed. So sad to see that. And I really didn't know about her until I've heard of her, but I didn't know her story. So I was doing some research and reading about her, and really just an amazing woman and does some really cool things.
Same. I wasn't familiar with her. I don't follow a lot of, the car racing and things like that. And so I was reading about her last night, and man, she was so driven and just really talented. And it's just sad news, especially hearing, of someone's death so young and doing what they love to do. It's just so tragic.
Very tragic. Yeah.
So also trending this morning, binge drinking is trending. A new study is out and it says that calories from binge drinking are equivalent to a double cheeseburger. Whoa. Okay. Having four or five drinks on one occasion is somewhere around 550 calories or more. So on average, drinkers ingest about 250 calories from alcohol per day, which is the same as eating a bag of chips every day. The study also showed that 52.5% of drinkers get their calories from beer, 21% from wine, 20% from spirits, and 6.5% from ciders or coolers.
So what was it? How many drinks? Six?
They're saying four or five drinks on one occasion is considered binge drinking.
When's the last time you had five drinks on one occasion?
I can't even tell you. I don't even know. When Steph and our husbands went out, I think I had three that night. We didn't have a ton of drinks, did we?
No, I think you're right. We all, or me and you had about three.
Matt didn't drink. Did James have more than three?
I don't think he had three. I think he had two.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, because we got that final glass. We got the final drink upstairs. We went to the club.
You guys went clubbing in the club.
And then at one point, I was like, I don't even want this drink anymore. I'm like, Steph, do you want some of this wine? So I made her start drinking my wine.
Sure.
Also trending this morning, Matthew McConaughey is trending. The actor is now a new professor at the University of Texas.
All right, all right, all right.
Yeah, he has been appointed as professor of practice to the Department of Radio, Television, and Film faculty starting this term. Now, he's been co-teaching a class called Script to Screen since 2015, but this fall he is a full-on instructor, which means he can mentor students, he can explore teaching other classes, and he can participate in all of the university's events. Now, that doesn't mean he's going to be there for every class. The school says that the frequency that he'll attend the script to screen course this fall all depends on his schedule, but How would you like to walk into class the first day and see Matthew McConaughey there?
That'd be cool. I take him as a professor in any class. Yeah, this is awesome. Matthew McConaughey.
All right, all right, all right.
And then he's there for one class, and then the substitute professor comes in because he's filming a movie.
Yeah, he's like, all wrong, all wrong, all wrong. He earned a film degree from the school in 1993, so he's a big University of Texas fan. You see him at all the Longhorn games, and he's there officially. That's kind of cool. And then finally this morning, TSA is trending. They have banned those little souvenir bottles that you can purchase at Disney's Star Wars Land Galaxy's Edge. Have you seen those before?
I've seen the pictures this morning, yes.
They're round and they have like a funky cap on them. And they say that they look like they're explosives. Each bottle, it's this rounded design in the resealable cap, and they're not allowed in either your carry-on or your checked-in bags. You cannot travel with them at all. They are exclusively sold in the park in Anaheim, and then starting today in Galaxy's Edge, Orlando. So if you were hoping to bring one home for a souvenir, you're going to have to drive it back, people. You can't pack it.
They were talking about the one in Orlando opening up this weekend with Labor Day weekend, but there's also that hurricane that's coming through.
Yeah.
It might be a little damper on the opening of Galaxy's Edge in Florida, at least.
That's Hurricane Dorian, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. And how they name all the hurricanes. I'm like, oh, okay. So someone's name's going to forever be associated with this terrible, tragic work of Mother Nature. So there you go. That is what's trending.
Welcome to another episode of Mercedes in the Morning, show number
1025.
And now, here's your hosts, Mercedes and JC.
Good morning, 6 o'clock on Thursday. Welcome to the show. You know, some good news last night. Saw that the teacher strike, the teachers came to an agreement. So that was some good
news
yesterday. Happy about that. Reading about this woman this morning who's going on a hunger strike because her favorite Netflix show is not getting renewed. Did you ever watch The OA?
Did not.
No. Wonder if it was good.
Can't join her in her hunger strike.
Yeah, obviously it was good enough for a hunger strike.
Oh, speaking of shows, last night was the season finale of Yellowstone. Have you got into that one yet?
Nah.
The Kevin Costner one?
No.
Oh, it's turning kind of into like Sons of Anarchy-ish.
Uh-huh.
The first season, you really got to stick with it. Season two, it's like a fine wine. It just opens up. It's amazing. And it's very kind of Sons of Anarchy-ish feeling to it. And last night was the season finale, and I was crying.
Oh, good stuff.
It was cute. It was good. I was like, oh. I'm gonna look at myself like, what are you doing, dude?
Is
it's a TV
show.
Is that
how you cry? Oh.
That's how it was last night.
Like, your crying sounds like laughing, actually.
I felt the tears coming on. I'm like, are you going to cry over this? I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm crying over the show right now.
Oh, man. That's sometimes it's good to fall asleep crying.
I read a book. And yeah.
So you took off the results of that cry.
Yes, the cry, yes. Oh, I took the dog out, and the cry was well past my well past me when I went to bed last night.
Did you go to bed early?
Last night, no. I went to bed around 9:45 last night, actually.
Oh, that's late for you.
It is. I'm doing this thing, and maybe we'll get into it later on, but it's called 75 Hard. It's like a diet. It's a lifestyle thing that you got to do for 75 days, and I started it yesterday was day two, and one of the things, little things in this 75 days that you're doing is you have to read 10 pages a day of like a motivational type book. At least just do 10 pages a day of some kind of book. And so last night I was ready to go to bed. I'm like, I didn't do my 10 pages. So I got my Kindle out, actually, and I started reading last night in bed, and I read more than 10 pages, and that kept me up late last night.
Oh, okay. So do you have to read for this thing?
There's diet, there's exercise, there's all these
like
things.
It's like a whole mind-body-soul thing?
Exactly. And one of the things is reading 10 pages a day. And so I was all set. I did everything I was supposed to do yesterday. Get ready to go to bed. I'm like, all right, go to bed. And like that, I remembered I got to do my 10 pages. Started reading and just got into this book.
Do you have to, does reading like social media count?
No, I was thinking the same thing too.
I'm not going to do it.
How was your night last night?
It was good. Last night we had both of our girls had back to school night, so we had to split. And my husband went to my youngest back to school night, which was like a half hour, and I had to go to my oldest back to school night, which was 2 hours.
Oh, did you know that going in, or just kind of you roll the dice? Oh, see, so you drew the longer straw. Yeah,
because
the long evening?
With my youngest, you have one teacher's class to go to, and with my oldest, I had 8 teacher's classes to go to. So, and the way they have it, it's like periods. So, you know, the bell rings, then you walk over to the next class, and you sit in their class, and they talk about the school year. Then the bell rings, and you go to the next one. And so, I was there for 2 hours yesterday doing that, and it was. I mean, actually, I like it because I like to meet the teachers. I'd like to know who she's talking about when she tells me something about her class and stuff. And so we did that last night, and it's just so funny because I know like what her day is like where she starts, and then she has to walk over to this building, and then she gotta run. She only has 2 minutes. She's gotta run to this building. So that was actually cool. And then when I got home, she wanted to know, what did you think of every one of my teachers? So I have to go down the list. Well, this one I thought this. So it was fun though, you know.
Do you follow them on Facebook, or teachers? Do they tell you they address that, or once you meet a cool teacher, like, oh, I want to be friends with this teacher. She seems like a cool dude.
No, cool woman.
I
feel like that's like a line you can't cross. I have had teachers reach out to me after they were done teaching my child to like friend me on Facebook, and I always gladly accept them, but I've never reached out to them to friend them.
Is there a cross thing? Because maybe a teacher doesn't realize who your daughter is, and she's a fan of the show and fan of yours, and maybe following you, and then she gets Sophie as your student and realize, oh, wow, we are connected through social media.
I've never had that happen. Well, actually, technically, maybe I have. Through CrossFit, she's in the CrossFit club, and one of the instructors, he and I had knew each other through CrossFit before my daughter was even in his class.
Oh, nah, really?
So that was kind of funny, but we don't like hang out or anything like that.
All right, we got a lot going on for you guys this morning. A $250 promo card to Living Spaces. That is happening in the 8 o'clock hour. 15 minutes from right now, those VIP tickets to the Wallflowers, that's tomorrow night, downtown, Fremont Street Experience. Those tickets in 15 minutes. Thursday, Radio Truth or Dare, 8 o'clock. How you feeling about today's dare? I'm excited about today.
Are you?
Yeah.
Is this the one that you would actually want to get?
I mean, I think it's going to be very entertaining. I don't think it's going to be too painful. There's nothing too bad in it. It's going to be a fun one today.
I think it'll be a little stressful, but it could be fun.
Entertaining.
And history could be made on this show today.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just leave it at that.
All right, coming up here in the dirt, if you look up tough in the dictionary, you're going to find a picture of Kelly Clarkson. I'll explain coming up in 7 minutes. Mix 94.1, Mercedes in the morning. We have your tickets to the Wallflowers VIP tomorrow night. Fremont Street Experience coming up in just about 3 minutes.
We never gossip.
Or would we?
Let's go.
Time for the Daily Dirt on Mix 94.1.
If you didn't know, back in May, Kelly Clarkson, she was hosting the Billboard Music Awards, and her appendix burst on live TV. Now, we didn't know it was happening at the time because she just sucked it up, finished the show, and then had her appendix removed after the award show was over. Kelly Clarkson is tough. We're talking Chuck Norris tough. Because check this out. A week later, she was doing a live episode of The Voice when a cyst on her ovaries burst.
Oh, man.
And once again, she fought through it. She says, quote, I had to grab Blake Shelton's arm, and I was like saying, something is wrong. This is more painful than the appendicitis. So after her second trip to the hospital in a week, everything was patched up, and she's fine now. But, man, if one of those things happened to me, I'd be down. I'd be out of here.
Yeah, no kidding. But ladies are tough, I'm telling you.
Yes. Did you see the trailer for the new Joker movie that's coming out in October?
I did. It looks so good.
We have, let me give you some of that right here. It was just released yesterday. Of course, it's Joaquin Phoenix starring as the Joker. Here's some of that.
For my whole life, I didn't know if I even really existed. But I do. And people are starting to notice.
You think this is funny? Is this a joke to you?
Oh, that was Robert De Niro doing that.
Yeah.
I didn't realize he was in the movie.
I know. Is he playing like a Johnny Carson type character? He's a late night talk show host.
Yeah, and part of the reason he turned into the Joker, it would look like, according to the trailer. So, yeah, it looks really good.
Yeah, it's coming out on October 4th. Taylor Swift, she admits that she carries wound dressing with her because she has a fear of stalkers. It's very sad to hear that, but she does it as a precaution. And listen to this. Another stalker was just arrested near her home in Rhode Island. According to TMZ, a man was caught trying to enter the gate of her mansion. And when they confronted the guy, he claimed that he was on the phone with her and he was there to marry Taylor Swift. Luckily, the man, he didn't have any weapons on him, and he was arrested and taken in. But that, I feel like she's dealing with this all the time.
Yeah, she's the biggest star in the world, and it's no excuse. But yet, these people are crazy. I think they feel like they know her, and they have the right to do that. It's terrifying. I feel so bad for her.
Her new album, by the way, Lover, is just crushing it. As of Tuesday, it has moved 750,000 units. Could she hit the million mark? Do they stop? Because it went on sale last Thursday at 9 or dropped Friday morning? Dropped a week ago on Friday. Wasn't sure if it went out Thursday night or not.
I had it Thursday night because I was listening to it on Thursday night. Yeah.
So maybe the sales at some point stop today. Will she hit that million mark? Who knows? But she's killing it. And then last one here. The nominations for this year's CMAs have been announced. And Maren Morris leads the pack with 6. And here's some really good news. The category of Entertainer of the Year is not a total boys club again. Carrie Underwood was nominated.
Oh, good.
It's the first time in 3 years that a woman is up for the award. It made no sense to me. In the past, there's women that are, you know, best female artists, but she doesn't carry over into Entertainer of the Year. It made no sense.
Yeah, like how can you not
be in there,
that
right?
Honor.
Okay, let's do this right now. Your tickets to go see the Wallflowers. You remember when they did the cover for the Godzilla movie? Like, I think it was in 1998. They covered David Bowie for that movie. Caller 20, 702-364-9400. That's you. You're playing Heads Up.
All right. We have 2 categories for you to choose from. So you get to pick the one you want. You also get to pick your partner. And if you get 6 in 60 seconds, you're going to win. Caller 20, you're playing 702-364-9400.
It's time for Heads Up with Mercedes in the Morning on Mix 94.1.
Hey, Mary.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, good morning. You're caller 20. You're playing Heads Up.
All right, Mary.
Woo. I'm so excited.
All right, let's pick a category. Do you want to go with pups or perfect match?
Pups. Yes.
Pups.
Yes.
Okay. National Dog Day was this week, so these are all famous dogs, okay?
Oh, my God. Okay.
All right, who do you want to pick as your partner?
I'll take JC.
All right.
All right, Mary, it's all about dogs here. We got 60 seconds on the clock. You get 6 correct. You're going to go see the Wallflowers VIP style tomorrow night. You ready?
Okay, yes.
We start now. This one would roll around in the Mystery Machine with Shaggy.
Scooby-Doo.
Correct. This one was Dorothy on Wizard of Oz, her dog.
Toto.
Yes. Toto, not Dodo. This one on Disney. This third one here, Disney. Not Goofy, but...
Pluto?
Nope. Yes. Charlie Brown's dog.
Snoopy.
Yes. And then this is a big red dog. He's featured in books.
Clifford.
Yes. And then the final, Disney, not Pluto, but he's a character on Disney.
Goofy?
Yes!
Who was your partner in that one, Mary?
My daughter, Vanessa.
A nice job, Vanessa and Mary. Congratulations.
Yeah. I liked when it was Toto. They said Dodo.
Toto.
Wait,
that's Alina her.
Congratulations. VIP tickets to see the Wallflowers tomorrow night, Fremont Street Experience. Way to go.
Awesome.
You're welcome. Enjoy. And more chances for you to win with Heads Up this morning. In the 8 o'clock hour, we have a $250 promo card to Living Spaces.
That's Panic at the Disco. This is Mix 94.1, Mercedes in the Morning. Bite of Las Vegas is happening on Saturday, September 14th. And today, from noon to 1, you got a chance to score yourself some tickets.
Yeah, all you got to do is stop by the McDonald's on Eastern and Windmill. We are going to be out there. Mix 94.1 will be out there, and you'll have a chance to get tickets. Also, if you can't get there during that hour, stop by at some other point, any participating McDonald's, to get $5 off your Bite of Las Vegas tickets. That's the only discount that's being offered for Bite of Las Vegas tickets. So if you want to get $5 off, stop by and get the code word there so you can get your tickets.
Let's be honest. Years past, it would pop up on Groupon. We do a Groupon thing. We're not doing that this year. That's not
Groupons.
Happening. So hit up at McDonald's for those discounted tickets. And, of course, all the information online at mix941.fm. As a kid, did you ever stumble into an R movie or accidentally take your daughters in to see an R movie? Because this happened to my buddy of mine about 2 weekends ago. He thought, he's taking his boys to see what he thought was maybe PG-13 or just a PG movie. Turned out to be an R movie. And he realized it about 10 minutes into the movie.
What was the movie?
I wrote it down because it was like 2 weeks ago. It was the Good Guys. It's that one, the guys from Superbad made it. And
oh, it's about the two kids?
Yeah, adolescent teens. It's like Superbad. Yeah, Good Boys. Thank you, Jocelyn. It's like Super, my buddy said it's supposed to be like Superbad, but younger. Like the kids they focus on are younger than McLovin in the
right.
last set of kids. And so he brought his son and his son's friend, buys the tickets, goes in there. He said, watching it within the first 10, 15 minutes, realize this is not right. This is an R movie.
What was happening?
He
on
didn't
it?
Tell me what the scene was. Oh. Just that they left within 10 minutes and they went to see another movie that was playing at the same time. So he went in with all good intentions to bring his son and his friend to go see Good Boys. And you get in there and realize, uh-oh, maybe not appropriate for an 11-year-old to see.
I wonder if the 11-year-old will remember that as the first rated R movie they ever saw. And if so, do you remember yours? What was it? Or maybe you accidentally exposed your kid to 1-702-364-9400. My kids still give me a hard time about when I did it. I didn't know it was rated R. Did you know The Bodyguard is rated R?
PG-13, maybe.
No,
how's it rated R?
It's rated R. I thought it was PG-13. So I thought, okay, I'm pushing the envelope a little bit with them, letting them watch The Bodyguard. But at the time, like, Sophie was really into Whitney Houston. And I was like, oh, we got to watch The Bodyguard. So we start watching it. And they keep looking at me like, Mom. Because there was like really bad language. Really bad, and more so than your occasional little, bomb here and there. And then I can't remember the scene, but I remember there was one scene I was like, oh my gosh, like just trying to forward through it. And she's texting me right now. She's like, The Bodyguard. I'm like, I know. I did not know it was rated R, but she says it was such a good movie. But yes,
it was soundtrack too, to boot.
Yes, exactly. So what was your first rated R movie? Do you remember it, or when did you accidentally expose your kid to a rated R movie? Brad, what was it for you?
Hey, so when I was working at my bar, the movie Sausage Party was on the trailer, and it's an animated movie, and Seth Rogen and a bunch of those guys did it, and it's really, really graphic and gore, and like vulgar, and I was going to take my kids to it until we watched the trailer 5 minutes before we got to the movie theater. And I'm like, there is no way I'm letting my kids watch this.
Oh, man. Whenever it looks like a cartoon, you think, oh, cartoons, of course. What was the other one that the South Park guys made? It was puppets.
Oh, yeah, Captain I see it. Mr. Universe or Captain Something.
Captain Something. And I know a lot of kids went and saw that, and they were very shocked after that happened. Steph, you remember your first rated R movie?
I remember going to the movies with my uncle and my dad, and I went to see a separate movie, and they watched Saving Private Ryan. And they said, when you're done with the movie, just wait in the lobby. But I didn't go in the lobby. I just said, oh, I'll just go find them in their movie. When I walked in, I was traumatized.
Oh,
intense
movie.
Bad movie.
It was so, that for any age, just seeing that.
Yeah.
I'm 7 years old, I can't even imagine. Kylie, what about you?
My parents took me to see 8 Mile when I was 11 years old.
Oh, wow.
What did they base that on? That's a good song.
Yeah, my mom loved Eminem, and that scene came on with Brittany Murphy, and I was like, oh, God, it's melting my chair.
I know. That's the exact scene I thought of when you said that. I'm like, oh, you're 11. How do you explain that scene to your child?
I wasn't, because it was R, and we were not old enough to see it, but I remember my buddy, Sean Tuchel, and I, when The Breakfast Club came out, it was in theaters, and his mom dropped us off to go see it, and we go walking in. They're like, you guys are not old enough to see this movie. I'm like, we can't. And like, we couldn't see the movie, and this is before cell phones, so we couldn't get in touch with his mom, so we just played in back of the movie theater for 3 hours until she came to pick us up.
Oh, really?
Because we couldn't get in to see The Breakfast Club.
There was no other movies playing?
At the time, I forget. We're just like, I don't know, go outside and play. We played behind the movie theater. And then I remember seeing The Breakfast Club for the first time. I'm like, man, I wish I saw that when I was younger, because that's a kind of a life-changing, eye-opening movie when it comes to school and cliques and how you should handle people. And I think my life, my school path would have been different if I would have seen that movie when I was in school.
I wasn't allowed to see that movie when it was out either. Mm-hmm. I didn't see it until I was much older.
Yeah.
And I remember we actually did, I want to say in high school, we ended up watching it in class to study the whole click thing. Like, it was a whole assignment.
Yeah.
But I was shocked at a lot of it. And then you see the TBS version, the edits.
Oh, yeah.
That they make. And they edit out all the good parts. It's a totally different movie when you
down.
See it on TBS. It's not even the same.
Team America, World Police. That's the one we're looking for. All right, we got the Hot 3 coming up. What do you have?
All right, CCSD and the Teachers Union reach a deal after weeks of negotiation. We're going to talk about that. Also, we crave this 122 times a month. What is it? And a guy's crazy but maybe genius plan to get his hands on these tickets has a lot of people talking. Tell us if you think you would do this for your favorite sports team. It's all coming up next in the Hot 3.
I'm a sucker for you. Jonas Brothers Sucker. It's Mix 94.1. Mercedes in the morning. Yes, it's Thursday morning, so that means we have Radio Truth or Dare, and we kick it off at 8 a.m.
The latest news updates happens now. It's the Mercedes Hot 3, Mix 94.1.
The Hot 3 is brought to you by the College of Southern Nevada, now enrolling for fall semester.
So this is some great news. The teachers' union reached a deal with the Clark County School District after weeks of negotiations over teacher contracts. And the deal comes as board members or members of the union, the Clark County Education Association, they had been preparing to strike on September 10th. Now, at a press conference, the Board of Trustees president said it had been a tense few weeks, but they were happy to announce that a strike had been averted. The final deal reached all of CCEA's previous demands, and that includes the 3% adjustment for every employee in the bargaining union unit with an adjustment of the current salary schedule. They were talking about that professional growth system and how they would be reimbursed.
They are getting reimbursed,
that.
Okay.
Yes, so some great, great news on that. But she did go on to say that teachers can't continue to teach in overcrowded classrooms, and the district needs to try to figure that out because the class sizes are getting out of control.
Are teachers, are they truly happy with this? Because all the news, everyone's saying that teachers are very excited, very excited. Teachers, are you happy with the final outcome?
Yeah, let us know. I'd be very curious to hear if this is exactly what you wanted, or is this a good starting point, and now you can kind of move here and say what else needs to be done.
Mm-hmm.
Because I do agree the class sizes are pretty out of control sometimes.
Do you think they will address it? The officials saying, and we will address that issue, by the way. Okay, will you?
Yeah, I don't know.
You're saying you will, but will we really address that issue?
I feel like it's that you've tamed them down for the time
yes,
being
for the next year,
yeah,
maybe two, if that.
We'll see. So, yeah, let us know what you guys think. 702-364-9400. Also this morning, apparently we spend a lot of time dreaming about junk food. According to a new survey, the average adult has a craving for junk food like chocolate or potato chips 4 times a day. That works out to about 122 cravings a month. So do we give in? Absolutely. 40% of people say they will wind up eating junk food after half of those cravings. And 1 in 8 people eat junk food every time they want it. The cravings are most likely to kick in at 3:31 p.m. And if you're going to give in, it usually happens at 3:50 p.m., Now, the top junk foods we want are chocolate, potato chips, cheese, cookies, cake, and ice cream. Candy is on there also. Other types of chips, bread, soda. Those are some of the other things we crave.
Do you get a craving? And if so, what time during the day?
I think my craving, I guess at night after dinner, I'll want something sweet. Like I like having a handful of gummy bears or something like that. That's probably my worst time at night, right before bed. I want something. What about you?
Mine's at night as well, but it's as soon as I'm done dinner. I take the last bite of whatever I'm eating, and my mind is like, cookies! You need cookies. Like, it's still chewing the chicken. It's just swallow the chicken. My mind knows that dinner is done and I need something sweet. And that's when I'll go grab some cookies.
That's what I feel like with me, that after the main meal, there's a, you know, there's a sentence. And it's, every sentence needs a period at the end of it. And I feel like the sweets, the cookies, the candy,
right?
That's the period to end the night, right?
Why can't the sentence just keep going on? I don't want...
The ellipsis, .. Amanda is a teacher, wants to make a comment on the deal that was reached. Hi, Amanda. Are you happy this morning? How are you feeling?
I'm semi-happy.
Why semi-happy?
Because the deal is only for the next 2 years, and like they've done where the raises came before... And then they freeze it again for like another 4 years. And then we have to go through this whole process again to get a raise.
Oh, so you've been appeased for the moment, and we'll see what the next 2 years brings. Yeah, that's, we're getting some texts here too. As a teacher, this settlement is exactly what we requested for the current moment. Today, this is a win, but there are many more battles ahead. This one says, is this a permanent fix or is this a Band-Aid being put over a problem? And we're going to be here again in the future. So, interesting.
And did they want then, because they got, what, 3% this year and another 3% next year, did they want a 6% raise? Was that they were going for, but they're just now stretching it out? Because if that was the case, like, no, I want my 6% now. I want more money this year and next year. I want a double. Come on.
Is there a middle ground that you have to be willing to meet? I don't know.
Compromise.
It just seems like it's a long time coming. This text, or actually tweet, just came in. School funding is a state issue, and while averting a strike is great, this will not bring increased funding into classrooms nor reduce class sizes. So very true there. All right. Finally, this morning, Green Bay Packers season tickets. They're incredibly hard to get. There's a waiting list of well over 130,000 people, and it usually takes at least 30 years. Well, there's a 35-year-old guy named Matthew McLaughlin of McFarland, Wisconsin, and after 10 years on the list, he's still in the 70,000s. So he has come up with an offer to get tickets. That's insane, but might just be genius. Here are his three proposals that he laid out in a Craigslist post, okay? One, he said he will pay someone $10,000 to take their spot if they are under 1,000 on the wait list. To pull that off, he will legally change his name to their name so the Packers won't know it's a different person buying the ticket.
So it looks like next to kin or something.
Yeah, like, oh, your name is Charles Jenkins? Okay, I'll change my name to Charles Jenkins and then I can just buy those up. The second order is that he'll pay an older person with season tickets $109,000 to leave him the tickets in their will. But since the Packers have strict rules about that, he'll cover the fees to have them adopt him. And he'll also send Father's Day or Mother's Day gifts. Okay? Or the third option is if a single woman or man has season tickets, he'll pay them $10,000 to marry him. Then they can get divorced and transfer him the tickets during the settlement. He says, quote, we can time it correctly so we maximize our joint tax refund too.
That one sounds good, right? If you're single and for some reason you have two tickets to the Packers, work that deal out. Then you got to sit next to the guy and he can't bring a friend to any games.
Well, I think the whole idea is to get the divorce before you have to go to any games.
Yeah,
and
but
then he gets the tickets.
He gets the tickets. But then, like, if you have two extra tickets to the Packers game and he gets those two tickets, then you can't bring friends to the game. And then you'll see your ex-husband or...
That you don't
time,
even
yeah,
know.
Yeah, every time you go to the game.
Well, surprise, he hasn't gotten any serious offers yet. He probably won't. His post has since been flagged for removal, so it's no longer viewable. But if you know anyone that's looking to make some decent cash that has Green Bay Packers season tickets, this might be the way to do it. So there you go.
It's Dan and Shay. The song is Speechless. This is 4.1, and you're listening to Mercedes in the Morning. Coming up 1 hour from right now, we got Radio Truth or Dare.
It's 7 o'clock Thursday morning, like you said. I'm trying not to make a big deal out of it, because in the grand scheme of things, it's really not a big deal. But have you ever been thrown under the bus by a family member. And my daughter is adorable. And she was really upset that I was upset last night. And everything is good now. But it was so funny because she got a little teary-eyed because she did something that kind of threw me under the bus. And she didn't mean to do it. It was a total accident. And last night, you know, she was kind of tearing up about it. I was like, it's fine. It's fixed. Don't worry. But when were you kind of thrown under the bus by a family member? 702-364-9400. So last night, there's one of my oldest daughter's schoolmates. She makes jewelry. She makes really cool jewelry. And she uses like those crystals that you were talking about, mm-hmm. like your wife is really into. They're like different rings and different bracelets. And she puts whatever crystal that you need in the jewelry.
Much like Spencer Pratt has his Pratt Daddy crystals. Your friend has her crystal line. This is nice.
Oh, are his crystals jewelry or are they just crystals?
It's just jewelry, yes.
Oh, yeah. I didn't realize that. Yeah. I thought it was just like, here's a handful of crystals that you can buy.
No, it's the whole jewelry line,
yes. Okay, see, I didn't know that.
She has a younger Pratt Daddy crystals. I love this. She has probably cheaper, too.
They're really cute, too. Uh-huh. And so my youngest daughter, ever since I gave her that crystal your wife gave me, she's kind of into them. She's looking at crystals on Amazon. She's not looking at Pratt Daddy crystals. But then she found out that one of Sophie's friends makes jewelry mm-hmm. out of crystals. So she last night is like, look at this ring. Isn't this cool? And I was like, oh, yeah, that's really cool. And she's using my phone to show me. And then I see her tap. And then it's another ring. She's like, oh, this one's supposed to help you with stress. And I was like, oh, that's really cool. And then she taps again. And I realize we're on this girl's story. And I go, wait a second. Who's Instagram are you on? And she's like, yours. And I was like, what? Because she's on my phone showing me this. And I said, so now this girl is going to think that I'm going through her Instagram stories and I don't even know her. She's going to look at who watched her story and think it was me. And she's like, oh. I'm like, yeah, oh. So I just didn't want Sophie's friends to think I was like stalking their Instagram. So I'm like, Brooklyn, you got to go on your own Instagram mm-hmm. if you're going to look at these things. I don't want people to think I'm watching their stuff when I don't even know them. She got upset. She's like, I'm so sorry.
Aww.
And I was like, it wasn't that big of a deal. It really wasn't.
No, but at the same time, what if the girl is, you know, she's got jewelry, pictures, see, jewelry. And then all of a sudden, hey, like sassy pic of, you know. And then she sees that you saw a sassy pic or something. You just don't want that on her. You don't want her thinking you're watching all of her stories. I see where you're coming
like
from.
Like her friend's mom is going through her stories.
Yes, yes.
That's like, kind of weird,
right? Spying on me? What's going on? Yes,
so,
absolutely.
So I told Brooklyn, I'm like, please, you know, don't watch things on my account. Watch them on your account. And she was upset. But
has she been doing it? Like going through and watching other stories? And is she liking photos? And she commenting on photos?
No, I know she doesn't do that. Okay. She knows better than that. But she will grab my phone sometimes to look up things uh-huh. because it's just easier. My phone's there, her iPad. She doesn't have a phone. And so she kind of threw me under the bus in that way. And it was funny when it was all said and done. But I felt bad because she felt bad. Has that ever happened to you where maybe it was a kid, maybe it was a sibling, maybe it was your parent just kind of threw you under the bus where you're like, well, what am I supposed to do now? Why'd you do that to me?
Dude, my wife will like volunteer me for things. In essence, I feel like it's kind of throwing me under the bus.
Yeah.
Because she is in San Diego right now for work, and then that's turning into some horse show stuff this weekend. And the plan was for me to head out there this weekend as well. And she, we had to drive out with the dogs on Saturday, and she kind of volunteered me for other people to ride along at the barn. Oh, JC's heading out Saturday morning. If you want to ride out with him, because it's a long weekend,
yeah,
you can ride with him. Like, what? That's a long drive with someone I might not be that friendly with.
Oh, that's the
like, worst. No, she's awesome. Like, I know she seems like an awesome woman and kid, but I don't know them. I don't know them well enough to be in a car because I feel like I have to entertain them for 6 hours to be in a car with someone driving to San Diego. So thankfully, I forgot that I have a radio station event Saturday afternoon. You know what? I totally forgot. I got this. I can't make it out this time. She's like, all right.
Which so got me. A friend is like, well, I'll just hang out with JC this weekend.
but she said, you just volunteer me to drive someone. I really don't. It'd be awkward just driving with this person across town, let alone driving to San Diego with him.
You just made me feel really bad because I'll do that. Do you think that's throwing volunteering your spouse for something is the same as throwing them
yes.
under the bus?
What is the last thing you volunteered Matt for?
Well, I always volunteer him. I just did this on Saturday night. Someone's daughter really likes photography.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, oh, my husband's a photographer. He'll help her. Does she want a lesson? Let me know. I'll set it up. And my husband was literally right there. And he's like, yeah, sure. Of course. I would love to. And I could see him. I was like, oh, whoops. Just when you have this awesome skill or you have this awesome car, you want people to be a part of it and enjoy it.
Would you want to be 6 hours in a car with someone you... It's just casual hellos. How's it going? I've never really had a full-blown conversation with this person.
Who knows? This could be life-changing. It could be someone that you were meant to meet, and this was the... And your wife just did you an incredible favor.
Well,
by,
not happy. I'm like, no. Yeah, any work opportunities this weekend, sign me up.
Anyone want their yard cleared? I'll do it.
I'll teach your friend photography. I don't know photography, but I will give them photography lessons.
Oh, man. Okay, I got to stop doing that then. Someone just texted us saying, it's not volunteered, it's voluntold. You're doing it.
Yep. Coming up here in the dirt, Liam Hemsworth might have already found a new lover. Who is it? Details in 7 minutes. I will go, go, go. Bite of Las Vegas is happening September 14th. That's right around the corner. I'm still trying to soak in the fact that this weekend is Labor Day weekend.
I know. Where has the year gone? Seriously, we're going to be singing Christmas carols here before we know it. But yes, it's what, 2 weeks away?
2 weeks away, yeah. 2 weeks from Saturday, downtown Las Vegas Event Center. Where else can you get 8 hours of music for $25. Get your tickets right now. Mix941.fm.
We never gossip. Or would we?
Let's go.
Time for the Daily Dirt on Mix 94.1.
This is a fun tabloid rumor. Liam Hemsworth has turned to a friend to help him deal with his divorce from Miley Cyrus. That friend is a former co-star. Can you guess who that friend is?
I don't know any of Liam's former co-stars except for Miley, unfortunately.
I forgot about this one as well.
Okay.
Hunger Games. Remember who's in the Hunger Games?
Oh, Jennifer Lawrence.
Jennifer Lawrence.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Okay. I keep forgetting he was in Hunger Games. That's right.
They were love interests, weren't they?
Yeah,
they were brothers. They were love interests. Yeah.
What was his name? Start with a G.
Yeah, it was just G, wasn't it?
No, PETA was the other one, and
Gaylord.
Gage?
Was it Gage?
No.
Hey, I'm Gage.
It was something like that, I thought.
Gabriel. Gary.
I'm going to thing called Google. I'm going
to. No, it's so much better if we don't Google it. Gage.
I am PETA. Seriously, I think it was Gail.
Gail.
It was Gail. I was close, okay? Come on now.
Well, no doubt there was chemistry. Back in 2015, Jennifer Lawrence did admit on an episode of Watch What Happens Live that they once made out off screen. So there's some kind of chemistry between the two.
Oh, okay.
Again, tabloid talk, but wouldn't that be great if he got together with Jennifer Lawrence?
Well, I'm a PETA person myself, so no, I don't think it would be great.
90210 star Brian Austin Green revealed that he hooked up with his co-star Tori Spelling back during the height of the show. He called it a brief fling. Now, the tabloids, this is a very tabloidish dirt, by the way. Tabloids are saying that Megan Fox is mad at Brian for keeping this a secret. Would you be mad at your husband if it was revealed years later that he had a fling with a coworker that you've become friendly with over the years? Would you be upset?
I would be upset, just not because he had a fling. Like, everyone has a past. I totally get that. But if you didn't tell me and, like, you kept it a secret, that just... Why? I'll tell you about my flings. You tell me about your flings. Mm-hmm. We have flings.
Does he know about all of your flings?
It's not like I have a ton of flings to talk about, but he knows about my past. I don't hold anything back. And as far as I know, I think I know everything about his. So do you tell each other everything?
Yeah.
Would you be mad if you found out after the fact?
I did find out after the fact. Once I was at a wedding, and my wife was in the bridal party and they had a bridal table and stuff. So I had to sit in the crowd by myself.
Yeah.
And they put me at the single guys table because they were all single guys and I was by myself. And I was sitting next to a guy that my wife dated briefly. And I had no idea. We hit it off. We were chit-chatting the whole night. And it was the end of the night. And my wife's like, oh my gosh, you got real friendly with Stan. I'm like, yeah, he's a really cool dude. She's like, oh, well, we dated for a little bit in high school. And my wife talks like this now.
I know. Like, all of a sudden, it's so great that you and Stan are getting along.
All right. Well, I'm going to buy some Pratt Daddy crystals.
Pratt Daddy crystals. She loves those things. Oh, my gosh. Do you?
Wait, has she even seen them yet? I thought they just came.
She got them. They arrived.
Oh, I thought she was out of town. No, and she's waiting for them.
They came just in time. Her Pratt Daddy crystals arrived just as she was getting ready to leave to the airport. So she has them on. And I was telling Mercedes this. I don't know if the Pratt Daddy crystals are bringing her good luck or bad luck. She lands in San Diego. She gets to the rental car counter, realizes she left her wallet on the airplane. That is not fun. Calling Southwest. The plane's getting ready to take off to go to Washington, D.C. Calling me. She's got no money, no nothing. Gets to the airport. It was turned into lost and found.
Oh, well, that was nice.
Pratt Daddy crystals right there. Goes back to the rental car place. You know, we're now out of cars. We got nothing for you. Ah. Next thing you know, a Jeep rolls in. My wife loves Jeeps. She gets a free upgrade to a Jeep. Pratt Daddy crystals.
Why is it those crystals? It hasn't she been into crystals a long time?
Yes.
I mean, could it? What does a DB have that like makes the crystals work so much better than the other crystals?
Pratt Daddy crystals writes a little note. He writes a handwritten note that came with the crystals. I found out last night in the box. I'm like, look at this. Spencer Pratt wrote a little note.
You kind guys of are seriously fangirling over Spencer
you
Pratt.
You want to read the note? It's kind of a douchey note.
No, I don't.
It's very douchey. I'm like, this is a note you wrote, dude. Let me ask you this. Do you own anything from a movie or a TV show?
Probably. I'm having a hard time thinking of something right offhand. Why?
Because there's a big auction going on where a bunch of stuff from movies is going up on the block. Does any of this stuff jump out to you? Let me know. How about the Levi jeans that Heath Ledger wore in Brokeback Mountain?
Oh, that would be a cool piece of memorabilia, I guess.
Bidding starts at $15,000.
Okay,
those expensive Levi jeans.
Definitely not going to do that.
Would you want Elvis Presley's personal guitar?
Yeah, I think like I have some family members that would love that.
That'd be cool, right? I don't have the price on that one. Or RoboCop's outfit. Remember the movie RoboCop?
I never saw that movie, no. But I know I've heard of it. How much is that?
I don't have the price on that one, but that's okay. Up there. Your husband would love this. Barbara Streisand, some of her wardrobes.
He would love this.
He's a fan. Isn't he a fan of Barbara Streisand?
He's a fan. I don't know if he wants her wardrobe, but yeah, heck yeah, why not?
Or what about Sammy Davis Jr.'s passport?
No prices on any of those?
I only have the Heath Ledger price.
Oh,
the other
man.
Ones, I didn't
I'm
get
just
the
curious now.
The going price on those things. But if you want Sammy Davis Jr.'s passport, you can bid at natedsanders.com. Isn't he a character on 90210?
That's Steve Sanders.
Steve Sanders.
Good try.
And Nate owned the Peach Pit, right?
No, that was, it wasn't Nate. It was,
It was a Nate that owned the Peach Pit?
I don't think his name. You and all these names. Gail, Gage. Who owned the Peach Pit?
Nate!
Is it? Oh, Nat! It's Nat!
Nat!
Oh my gosh.
It's the Pratt Daddy crystals.
You know what's funny? When you start Googling a question and you see that other people have already Googled
you're not
it,
alone.
It makes you feel so good.
We are 30 minutes away from Radio Truth or Dare. How are you feeling about the dares? Or the dare, I should say.
Well, as the person who did the dare last week, I certainly don't want to get it 2 weeks in a row. However, this one could be more exciting than a punishment. I'll just say that. It could be kind of cool, and we could be making history on this show, hopefully.
That's right. We're 32 minutes away from Radio Truth or Dare. I kind of ruined someone's... I would say I ruined their vacation. The part of me feels like I helped them. Have you ever accidentally ruined something for someone? Because I went to get my car washed last night, and I pull up, and the attendant I'm very friendly with, because I go there a lot, and super nice younger guy, and I pull up, and he asks me, how's it going? I'm like, oh, it's great, you know, and I'm like, how are you doing? He goes, 2 more days. That's all he says. I'm like, oh, yeah, 2 more days till.
Everybody's working for the weekend.
Yeah, that's it, till the weekend.
2 more days till the weekend, baby.
He goes, 2 more days till my girlfriend and I go to the Bahamas. I'm like, cool. He's like, yeah, we're going for 7 days. I'm like, you worried about the hurricane? What? Yeah, there's a hurricane making its way to the Florida and the Bahamas. No, I didn't know. I'm like, yeah. And then I'm like, I think they said it's been downgraded. I'm not sure. He's like, I'll have to look.
Don't tell them about a downgrade when there ain't no downgrade.
I know, but I felt bad when I had informed this guy.
You'll be fine. Just go.
Just go, man. Live it up. Just think.
Oh.
Most tourists won't be going, so you'll have to run on the island. I felt so bad. But then also part of me was like...
It's a category 3 storm, they're saying.
My parents are in Florida right now. I know it's going to be a big one.
Oh, boy.
And this guy is going all excited about going to the Bahamas in 2 days. And I'm the one that had to inform him that there's a hurricane barreling down on the islands right now.
You should have just let him live in bliss and let someone else tell him. Now you're the guy. You're the one that ruined it.
Because, you know, then I went through the car wash and he probably called his girlfriend. Did you know there's a hurricane? She probably didn't know. Ruined their night.
I know, but I do see where you're going with it. You're just trying to help. But are you that person in your family that's always the, like, the Debbie Downer? The, like, wah, wah, someone will come home so excited about something, but you have to find the bad part about it. You're the one that points out something negative about it.
Personally, I don't feel like that. That I'm that person. I try to look for the positive in everything and keep real positive energy around me. But I just, even last night as the words were coming out, like, oh, what about the, I'm thinking, he doesn't know. Why are you the one? Because if he would have known about the hurricane, he probably would have said, yeah, 2 more days till I go to the Bahamas. Hopefully the trip will be able to go down.
Yeah.
The words were coming out. I'm like, he doesn't know. And you're about to tell him.
Sometimes you have to be that person to help. Because at the end of the day, you're trying to help. You're not trying to ruin his day, or are you? I mean, you didn't set out and say, I want to ruin this guy's day.
No, yeah, I don't want to ruin his happiness. It's just like, hey, like, I was thinking maybe he knew about the hurricane and was going to talk about, maybe he had a plan in place. Like, oh, yes, we're flying to Tennessee first to make sure the hurricane passes, and then we're flying down to the Bahamas.
I feel, though, that everyone needs that friend, though, who is that person. Maybe you're not always that person, but I think that, because I have a friend that I think she can sometimes fall into that category where one person might look at it as her being a Debbie Downer. Another person may look at it as, hey, she's the voice of reason. She's the realist. She's going to tell you, like, I'm excited because, I don't know. I just had a new car. Oh, well, there's a monthly payment you didn't need. Yeah, you're right. I should probably budget better. So, like, you're all excited about something. Oh, I'm going on vacation. Oh. So that takes away from your yearly allocation of what you get. Yeah, it does. Like, do you know anyone that's like that?
Can you Debbie Downer? Can I throw things at you and see if you can Debbie Downer them? And you're not a Debbie Downer.
I need to channel her because I...
Become this girl.
I'm trying to think of the things she said to me before. But I appreciate her reminding me that life is not always so great.
You just got a new car. You don't need Debbie Downer reminding you that you have a, you know, new car payment.
Yeah.
And then also the value of the vehicle depreciated the minute you drove off the lot.
Oh, you have a tendency to do that sometimes and remind me of those things. Also, I just realized that. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay. I'm looking forward to this weekend because I'm going to go to a barbecue on Saturday night.
Well, make sure you don't wear white because you'll probably get barbecue sauce all over your white shirt.
Well, Sunday.
Are you bringing something, by the way?
No.
I mean, it's rude to show up to a barbecue and not bring something.
Maybe.
Just don't bring anything with potato salad or like mayonnaise in it because it'll go bad.
I was thinking of bringing a bottle of wine, maybe.
Oh, yeah, because wine and barbecues, nothing says good barbecue like wine. But yeah, okay, go ahead, do that.
Okay, Sunday, I have nothing going on Sunday. I was going to sit out by the pool Sunday afternoon, enjoy the sun, enjoy the water.
Don't get skin cancer.
The West Nile outbreak, I guess you're worried about that too, aren't you?
I really am not like this,
I know you're
people.
Not.
I don't want people to just tune in and be like, wow, what's up her butt today? I really am not like that. Enjoy your barbecue. Have fun. Just wear a little sunscreen. That's all I ask as someone who cares about you.
Because you know someone just turned on the radio, heard nothing about the setup, and they're like, man, Mercedes.
Why are you always such a Debbie Downer, Mercedes? It's because you came into the station at the wrong time. I'm not always like this. I promise. I was imitating someone else.
That's the actual person that you're imitating, was it not?
Well, and she knows it because we always joke about how she's just, when you want blunt, well, I can't say the rhyming stuff.
You go to Emily Blunt.
Oh, yeah, that works too. She made up the rhyme for the record.
Hold on 1 second. You want blunt.
JC's writing it down. Yes, that's exactly what she says. She's like, you want blood? And we always laugh because she just says, I just don't pull any punches. And sometimes she's mean, but she embraces it. We love her for it. And she, I hope she's listening right now. She's probably like, they're talking about me. I know it.
All down about it. Radio Truth or Dare, they're going to do that bit again.
Everyone needs a friend like that. Yeah, she's probably rolling her eyes. She's probably just already changed the station out, honestly. Hey, by the way, people are saying you possibly saved your guy, the guy at the gas station's life by reminding him about that.
Yeah, I'd be the one informing him. Yeah, absolutely. He just went home, saving up for this vacation for an entire year. First time getting away with his girlfriend.
I'm sneezing over here. I probably got you sick. got your germs all over me now.
Great. Now I can't enjoy the 3-day weekend because I have a cold from Mercedes.
Oh, man.
Hot 3 is coming up. What do you have?
All right. Well, speaking of worrying about things, how many of us regularly worry about things that we just can't control? We're going to talk about this. Also, if you want to live longer, you got to be one of these. And trust me, it ties into what we were just talking about. And a woman... have you ever gone on a test drive, or maybe you sold cars, you go on a test drive and you worry about the person who's taking the test drive? We'll tell you about what one salesman had to go through with his test drive coming up next in the Hot 3.
There he is, our headliner for Bite of Las Vegas. That's Rob Thomas. Bite of Las Vegas happening September 14th, downtown Las Vegas Event Center, 40 restaurants. All the information online at mix941.fm.
All the news you need to know.
You're not going to want to miss this, folks.
It's the Mercedes Hot 3, Mix 94.1.
Okay, so do you ever catch yourself stressing about things that you can't even control? A new survey finds 55% of Americans do it on a regular basis. Now, the question they asked was, how often do you worry about things which are outside of your control? And 55% said very often or somewhat often. 35% said not very often. 7% claim that they never do. 3% didn't answer. How would you answer that?
I'm trying to get better about not worrying about things that are out of my control. I used to be bad. I'm getting better at it.
So you would say maybe like somewhat often? Not very often?
Not very often. Somewhat to not very. In between. Depends on the week. Where do you lie on that whole thing?
I would probably say somewhat often. I worry about things. I mostly worry about things for other people. And that's always out of your control. You can't control what other people do. So I'll do that. And it's just because you just want to make everyone happy and stuff. And it just, in the end, it makes you unhappy. So you have to control that. 62% of women say they do it compared to 47% of men. And millennials, they're most likely to do it than any other age group. 65% compared to 58% of Gen Xers. So the biggest thing that people say they'd like to simplify with their life, though, is finances. That was number one. Diet and exercise on there. And then their romantic relationships. So things that they'd like to just make a little more simple so they don't stress about it as much.
Love will come find you.
Love will find a way.
Love will find a way to find you.
Exactly.
Don't stress over love.
All right. So we were talking about my Debbie Downer friend who texted me, by the way, and thought that the conversation was hilarious.
Oh, good. Yes. Okay, good.
First positive thing I've heard her say in a long time. No, just kidding.
And it was wouldn't it be funny if it was a different Debbie Downer? It was someone else.
She thought it was her? Oh, no.
And she's not the Debbie Downer girl?
She wrote, listening, hilarious. So hopefully she wasn't being sarcastic.
And now I'm going to be late for work because I stayed in my car an extra 5 minutes to listen to you guys.
There's a new study out that says that being a glass half full kind of person can help you live longer. So you might want to change that train of thought if you're not. A new study finds that the most optimistic people have a higher chance of living to be 85 years of age or older, even when factoring behaviors like alcohol use, diet, exercise. The positive thinkers are found to live longer than pessimists.
I like that.
That's a total positive thing to say. I like that study. Well, that's a good study right there.
They say you are your thoughts. And we talked about this a couple weeks ago, about how just so many of our thoughts in our minds are negative.
Yeah.
Just constant negative thoughts in your mind about you're not good enough, you're making mistakes, this and everything, when actuality, that's not the reality. So you need to, and it's not easy to change your thought process, but you are your thoughts. You got to remember that.
There's a saying, like, if you think it will become it, or something
yes,
like that.
Exactly.
So, yeah, I totally agree. All right, finally this morning, I guess if you're test driving a car, you want to see how it'll perform, and all the different ways you'll use it. And for a few people, that includes police chases. There's a 32-year-old woman named Cassandra Ayala from Spokane, Washington. Excuse me. And she went to a Nissan dealer on Saturday for a test drive. But somehow, it turned into a kidnapping when Cassandra wouldn't let the car salesman get out. He called the cops, and they wound up in a chase with Cassandra. She started off driving slowly, but eventually sped up and wound up slamming into three police cars. Oh. The cops finally stopped her by intentionally ramming the car. It's not clear why Cassandra decided to turn her test drive into a kidnapping and a police chase, but although she did tell cops she had smoked meth earlier in the day, so maybe that was it. She is now facing several charges.
There's got to be a little anxiety if you work at a car dealership every time you go out on the road with someone, because you're not sure what kind of driver they are. Yeah, they got a driver's license, but you're not running a driver's license, a background check to see how they are as a driver.
Yeah, and you don't know how they're going to drive the car, too. Just when I do a test drive, I'm very, 10 and 2, very speed limit, mm-hmm. all that. But my husband is like, can we take it on the freeway? And you can see the guy's face or the lady's face like, oh my gosh, why did I get stuck with this guy?
I used to, as a teen, I used to go test drive cars all the time because I discovered like, oh, you can go drive a car for free at a dealership.
Yeah.
But I would go in and they wouldn't give me the time of the day. And this is not the case, but this is a lie I would tell the dealer. I would look at like muscle cars and stuff and like a Mitsubishi Eclipse or something. I'd be like, yeah, my dad's going to buy me a car and he told me I should come down and check out the Eclipse. Do you guys have them here? And they're like, oh, your dad's buying you a car? He's like, yeah, he wanted me to check it out. Well, right there, my dad's not buying me a car, but that's a line I would feed to the salesman, thinking that, oh, someone's going to buy this kid a car. Let's have him test drive it.
Oh.
So I would test drive. I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to come back with my dad. And I would never come back because my dad wasn't buying me a car. But that was the line that I used to do all these test drives.
That's kind of brilliant because then they think they got you.
This kid's daddy's going to buy him a car. Yeah. Oh, this is great. Easy sale. And then I would just never come back.
Your dad's like, you said what?
Yeah, what?
That's not happening.
It's Thursday. It's almost go time. Radio Truth or Dare. I got the dare. This is the new season, the fall season. I got the dare the first week. You got it week number two.
Who will get it this week? We're still up for it. It could happen to us again. It could happen to Steph. It could happen to Jocelyn. You just don't know. The one thing I do know is that there's a possibility that history will be made today on this show. Like, our names could live in infamy forever. Forever.
We do Radio Truth or Dare coming up in 4 minutes.
Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?
It's Mix 94.1, Mercedes in the morning, 8 o'clock hour, 8:25. We have for you a $250 promo to Living Spaces. They have a huge Labor Day sales event happening this weekend. You can definitely have some fun with that gift card this weekend. Right now, though,
Thursday, and this is episode 3 of Radio Truth or Dare. Okay, so this is your first time ever hearing this. This is how it works. We have our Cauldron of Doom, and in there we have two truth questions from old school Truth or Dare. Questions that are embarrassing, hard to answer, revealing, whatever. You have one dare. The dare is something you just don't really want to do, but you got to do it because you've been dared, and no one walks away from a dare on this show.
That's right. That is the rule.
And then the fourth piece of paper is a blank sheet of paper. So since there's four of us here on the show, one of us is not going to have to do anything this week. You're just merely an observer, and you get to enjoy life. Are we ready?
Let's do it.
All right. I'm going to draw.
Go ahead, my friend, draw.
All right. So last week, I got the dare. The week before that, JC got the dare.
Are you shuffling?
I did, yeah.
Really? You didn't go with your first one?
I swear to God.
No, I'm going to say, but sometimes do you just, because I shuffle too.
Oh, I shuffled last time and I got the dare. So I just grabbed the first one on this one. All right. JC got his. Who's here?
Okay. I'll go next.
All right, Steph.
And Joss.
Jocelyn. All right. Are we ready?
Pass that back to JC.
Oh, JC, there's the cauldron. Take that because we're going to need that for the dare.
Why are the phones going nuts, by the way?
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna grab one to see to make sure.
Here, hold on. Let me check.
Yeah, just double check. When all phone lines are blinking like a Christmas tree.
Hi. Hello? Good morning, Mix.
No one's answering?
Good morning, Mix. I don't know.
Okay, this is concerning. All of a sudden, you see all the phone lines light up. You wonder if something's going down.
Yeah, I know. Definitely. All right, are we all going to look at our papers now?
Yeah.
All right.
Ah.
Oh.
Ooh, I heard an ooh.
Well, oh. I got a blank one, so
you're
I'm
safe. Mercedes is safe.
Nice.
I'm very happy about that. JC, what'd you get?
I got a truth.
You got a truth? Okay, Steph.
I got a truth.
Jocelyn, you got the game. Oh, man. All right. Well, I'm going to tap out right here and just listen to
enjoy the ride. All right, Steph, what you got? You got a truth? Right. Go ahead, my friend.
Yes, truth. What makes you feel sexy?
Oh, wow.
Oh, man.
Okay. Let's go. I want to hear sexy stuff.
What makes me feel sexy? You know what? My husband, when he compliments me and he's like, like a physical attribute that I feel insecure about, he goes, honey, your nose looks sexy. Because my insecurity is my nose, which I know I shouldn't.
Oh, I love your nose.
Thank you. And James says the same thing, but when he compliments me on something that I'm insecure about, makes me feel sexy.
And when you feel sexy, do you make a sound? What's your I feel sexy sound?
Ooh, really?
we got the sassy look too.
Ooh, that's adorable. That was good. I like that. Okay, JC?
Okay, my question is, you have to trade lives with one member of the show. Who do you trade with and why?
Oh. Hmm. You can't trade with yourself. You can't keep your life. You got to pick one of us, me,
three
Jocelyn, or Steph.
Ladies, three beautiful ladies. Oh, you look like Charlie's Angels right there.
We're all wearing black today. Yes. Did you notice this? What are we all in mourning for?
You all have qualities that I admire and would want to experience. Mm. But when it's all said and done.
Me?
You, sister.
Oh, you don't want to be me. You do not.
You're like, no, you don't want this.
Trust me.
You don't want it.
I'm telling you now, pick one of them. No, I'm just kidding. No, I want to hear why. Why would you pick me?
Because I would want to experience your husband. No, I would want to experience. I would want
well, to. Let me tell you, speaking of feeling sexy.
I would want to experience motherhood because you aww. Have two beautiful daughters and we don't have kids and we're not planning on having kids. So I would want to experience what it's like to be a mom, even if I did have kids, experience from the other side, experience motherhood. What's that feeling like? Is there just something magic, this connection that you just can't explain to someone that doesn't have kids? That's what I would want to experience, the motherhood.
What about childbirth?
I would want to experience that too.
Just, yeah. I just made his nether regions hurt.
Yeah. It's like that. Oh, my gosh. If you're watching right now on Facebook, you're not going to have kids.
Sorry, I forgot we're on Facebook.
But that would be the main reason why, to experience motherhood with two kids.
Well,
yeah.
I'm very flattered. Thank you. Thank you for saying that. All right, Jocelyn, you're up, lady.
Mm-hmm.
Let's hear it.
Here, give me the...
Sorry.
All right. Here, can you get a better angle, Jocelyn? I don't want to just like, woo.
Right. Hi.
Okay.
Okay, this week I got the dare. Welcome to the Guinness Book of Records Challenge. The Guinness Book of Records was first printed this week back in 1955. Your task is to reach in the bucket and attempt to beat three records.
Okay. Three records in the Guinness Book of World Records. We could have someone break a Guinness Book of World Record today.
We got it on video or Facebook Live. This could be big.
We've got three chances at it, Jocelyn.
All right, Jocelyn.
Your name could go down in the Guinness Book of World Records.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going to pick three.
This
I'm
is what she will be attempting today.
I just grabbed three in one swoop, okay?
Okay.
So we're going to open this one really fast. This one is most sticky notes on the face in one time. So the current record is 58.
Oh, you can totally beat
okay.
that.
I can beat that.
All
okay.
right.
We'll go into detail later. This one is going to be, I hope it's a marshmallows one because I see marshmallows. Most marshmallows eaten in one time.
All right.
The current record is 25.
At one time? Okay. Oh, boy. Wait. And there's your last one.
And, most Jell-O eaten with chopsticks in
what
one
What was
time.
That one? Go ahead.
Most Jell-O eaten with chopsticks in 1 minute.
Okay, so after the break, Jocelyn's going to try to break one of these three world records, Guinness Book of World Records. One, the most amount of sticky notes on her face. Two, the most amount of marshmallows that she can eat in a minute. And three, the most amount of Jell-O eaten with chopsticks in a minute.
She's got it. She's got it. You're going to be in the book.
We'll see.
I mean, if anything, it's going to be a delicious morning for
right?
you. Oh, goodness, yes.
Jell-O and marshmallows.
We'll do it coming up here in 10 minutes. You might be one. We just kicked off 60-plus minutes commercial free, and coming up for you, this is great, a $250 promo card to Living Spaces that is coming your way in about 3 minutes here.
But first, we're on episode 3 of Radio Truth or Dare. JC and Steph got the truth today. I got the pass, and poor Jocelyn got the dare. Jocelyn, read the dare for everyone who might just be tuning in.
The dare is I have to complete 3 out of the 5 Guinness World Records that I pulled out of the Cauldron of Doom. The first one is the most sticky notes on the face in 1 minute, the most Jell-O eaten with chopsticks in 1 minute, and most marshmallows eaten in 1 minute.
And this is because the Guinness Book of World Records was first printed this week back in 1955.
Okay, yes. So we're trying to set new world records here. However, it's not official unless someone from Guinness is here to witness it. But as our good friend Shaw pointed out, who is here helping us film today, this is just in preparation so you can actually break the world record. Okay?
This is good. This is a good dry run. It's like a preseason.
All right.
All right. What's the first one we're doing?
Okay, we're going to do the most sticky notes on the face in 1 minute, and the current record right now is 58.
Okay, right. I have the timer ready. You let me know when you're ready, Jocelyn.
Okay, ready in 3, 2,
wait,
1.
Wait, hold on 1 second. No. Ready, set. Okay, ready, 3, 2, 1, go.
We got 1, 2. Oh, and they got to stay on her face or else they don't count.
I would push them on harder.
Yeah, she's not sticking them on, and she's sticking them to each other.
Oh, you're back to 1.
Oh, that's kind of...
Does that count? It fell off. How many we got? 5?
Five.
You have to go faster, Jocelyn. Come on.
6. Oh, three.
Now you're 4. Oh, no. This is not...
I have oily skin. It's not going to work.
Is that what it is?
Yes.
Is it oil on your skin?
Press harder. Press harder.
Oh, no.
Work the forehead. Work the forehead.
She's like, I'm going to mess up my makeup and my lashes. Leave
There's
me alone.
No makeup.
Can you do
no
it in your,
makeup.
Can you go hair? Can you put it in your hair?
No, that's not your face, JC. They're not
excuse me, Miss Guinness. How many have you done?
She's got 6. No, now she has 3.
They keep falling off.
Now she's got 3 again. Now she's got 3 again.
Okay, is this
4.
10 seconds.
You got 10 seconds.
5, 6. Oh, some fell off. Oh, no.
They're
4.
Not working.
5, 6. We learn our strengths, we learn our weaknesses.
Right, yes.
And this might have been a weakness, okay?
Those are big sticky notes, too. Maybe you got a smaller size one, but yeah, you try.
I bet the person who broke the record had a really big face.
And a dry face, too.
Yeah.
I'm oily as well.
Dry and big. Ah, I forget.
They got a big old head.
Okay. All right, so that didn't work out well, but this will work out well because it incorporates 2 things I know you like. Chopsticks and Jell-O.
Yes, I do enjoy some Jell-O.
What is this one again?
The most Jell-O eaten with chopsticks in 1 minute. I have to have 1 hand behind my back, and the current record is 32 ounces, which is 1 of these. So I got to get through 1 and some change.
3.2 ounces.
Okay, so here's the deal. We're on Facebook Live right now if you want to watch Jocelyn attempt to break this record. Should we take the wrapper off?
Those are nice chopsticks, too, by the way. Are they metal?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Are you ready?
Ready. Let's break some records here, girl. Chopsticks and Jell-O.
Starting now.
Okay, she's...
I can't even do it.
She's having some issues.
Should I hold it for her?
Okay.
Can you hold the... I don't think you can hold the cup for her.
It's really impossible.
Cup.
She's getting it. She's getting it now. Okay.
Use them as a... Use it like a spoon instead of trying to actually chopstick it. Use it as a spoon. Feed it to yourself.
It's not working.
I gotta say, watching this is so entertaining. I hope you're seeing this, but the sounds are pretty...
I'm not picking anything up.
I wonder if there's a trick to eating Jell-O with chopsticks.
No.
She's trying to pick it up. I think you need to use it like a spoon and just shovel it. There you go. Use your tongue.
But then what's the difference between that and a spoon with the world record? I think you are supposed to really eat it like chopsticks.
Come on. Oh, Jocelyn.
Slurp it up. Come on.
This is not going well for you.
10 seconds, baby.
Okay. Oh. So you got the person with a big face and dry skin, and then the person who did this one is probably very experienced with chopsticks, and the Jell-O is probably old, so
Time.
It was more sticky.
No.
0 for 2, Jocelyn.
I know, what the heck?
Okay, well, you know what?
Change your attitude.
Oh my gosh. So sorry, Mr. Fernandez.
Hey, no fighting, kids.
No, I just think of the mindset. Remember, you are what you think. And think you are a Guinness World Record holder. And this next one, you're going to dominate it. You're going to crush it.
I believe in you.
We'll see.
Okay, what's the last one?
The most marshmallows eaten in 1 minute. The current record is 25.
Okay.
So
envision yourself doing 30, going above this, okay?
Okay, Steph, does she have to show us a clear mouth when she eats it? Or do you know what the rules are on this?
In the rules, it doesn't say you have to show your mouth after she's done eating, but should we make that a rule?
Well, I just don't want you to choke on them. That's my thing. So I think you should have to chew it and swallow it before you put another one in your mouth.
Okay.
Woo! All right, 25 in a minute. You got this, kid.
You got this. It's marshmallows. Who doesn't love marshmallows?
These are pretty big marshmallows. I think I can do it, guys.
Okay, you can do it.
Ready? 60 seconds on the clock, and you start now.
All right, she's got her first one. She's ready for a second. Oh, look at that. We're at two already, baby. All right, let's do this. Come on, you got to get it in there. Come on, three.
You can chew loud, Jocelyn.
Come on. Yeah.
Don't make her laugh. Don't distract her.
All right, she's got... Now, this is our fourth one. You guys, we're on pace to break this world record. Four. Okay, she's got five in her mouth. Jocelyn, I believe in you. You can do this. This is your day. Let's go. Put number six in there. Number six is in there. Number six. We're at 30 seconds, so you've got a few to go, but it's okay. Seven. That's seven.
18 more to go.
All right. Come on, Jocelyn. Hey, I'm more surprised you did the math on that, Jason. All right. Sorry, Jocelyn. Eight is great. No, that was nine. I'm sorry. That was nine. Jocelyn, you've got 12 seconds left. You can 10. Come on. 10, 11. Oh, here she goes. 12. Oh, come on. You can do this. Do it. 13.
Oh.
And she's throwing them up.
Ew, she is. Ah! How many did you get?
She got 13, but then I think she just threw up six of them.
That's not bad, though. 13 and six. That's a show record for sure.
You did really well.
Thank you.
You know what? It may not be Guinness, but it's our show record.
Exactly.
So I'd like to see if anyone would like to challenge Jocelyn and get over 13.
To try to beat 13.
I'm going to pass.
I'm going to pass. JC?
I'm good.
Jocelyn, you hold the record in our hearts. And we're really proud of you.
Yay!
Oh, man. Jello and marshmallows for breakfast. I'm stomaching.
That was roasted marshmallows. Different story. You can plow those down, right?
You think? They're all hot.
Yeah, true. It's
burn your tongue. You did good. You're a good sport. Good try.
Nice job, Jocelyn. All right.
Steph is, she has avoided the dare up until now. Will she get it next week?
I'm nervous.
Oh, man.
We'll see you next week.
Let's put the
vibes her way for the dare. Oh, good try, you guys. Yay. All right.
All right, time to win right now. We have a $250 promo card to Living Spaces. You can shop the Living Spaces Labor Day event happening this weekend. Find amazing deals for the entire home. Caller 20, 702-364-9400. That's you. You're playing Heads Up.
Okay, we have two categories to choose from. Pick your category. Pick your partner. You get 6 and 60. You win. Caller 20 plays 702-364-9400. If I can't have you. Well, what do we have here?
What don't we have?
Phones. Our phones. I know a lot of you have been reaching out to us and texting us saying it's like really hit or miss on getting through on our phones. And from what we understand, they were rebuilding the server with
from
the phone.
From scratch. It's a process. Yeah.
So they've been working on that. But for some reason, the phones aren't working. So that means we could not get caller 20 and we cannot play Heads Up right now. Just, full disclosure. We're not trying to make any radio magic here. We're just going to tell you what's going on.
It's me playing around with phones. I can't pick up phones in here.
Will it dial out? No.
Yeah, see, you heard that weird thing. It doesn't dial out. Sometimes we get a dial tone, but we can't dial out. And they've been bad, but this is the first time ever that nothing comes through. And they showed the ringing too. Like, we started Radio Truth or Dare, our phones blew up. We thought something was going on. It was just the phones acting up, indicating that it looked like someone was calling, but they weren't. It's nuts.
Yeah, they're still ringing. So something is up with our phones.
Do you want to give out my cell phone number and caller one that gets through? We can do it on my speakerphone and my cell phone number.
Don't give out your cell phone number. If you, I got an idea. How about if you want to text us, I want to play, we'll see your cell phone number.
and then we can call them on your cell phone.
Okay, so the 20th text, because we always take the 20th text.
Okay.
This is good.
I wonder, though, if the phones are not ringing, will the texting happen? Let's give it a shot. 702-364-9400.
So the 20th text that comes in, just say, I want to play. Text, I want to play, or something like that. We'll take we'll call the 20th person back. We'll do my phone, put them on speaker, and that way we can all hear it.
I'm texting just as a test to make sure that the text goes through, because I have a feeling if the phones are down on
yours came through. I see test.
Okay, you do?
There's text number one.
Okay.
Oh, wow, we're blowing up. This is great.
All right.
Should I just find the 20th one?
Okay, wait, I'm counting them out. So that does not count. That was me. Oh, man, now I can't keep track of them.
Well, I'll call them, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to call someone right now.
Okay, that one is number 20 right there. So we're going to call them right now. This is...
I can't get track of the number. This one right here.
Here. I've screen grabbed it. You got it?
They're moving too fast. I'll screen grab the 20th one. The one he said right there? Okay. I screen grabbed the one.
Okay.
This is fun.
This is us trying to find a live caller right now. Let's hope this works. Thank you guys all for texting, though. This makes us feel good that you're still out there, because we can't
tell
with the
phones. All right, I'm going to call you on my speakerphone. Hold on one second.
Okay. And we're going to make this happen with Heads Up. We have a $250 promo card to Living Spaces that we need to give away this morning. All right. You got it?
Yeah.
JC's calling you, caller 20, or texter 20. I don't think we've ever done this.
Pick up.
That person's like, oh my gosh. Well, we know the text lines work.
Hello?
Hey, who's this?
Kara?
Tara?
Yes.
Hey, you're texter number 20. Yay! So you get to play Heads Up.
Sweet.
Oh my gosh, this is so hilarious. I kind of want to do this every time
but
now.
Wait. So then she can't hear you right now, though, because she's on my phone, so you got to come over here.
Well, it depends on who she picks.
Okay.
And I'll try to speak loud so you can hear. So you have a choice of two categories. Do you want to go with Bok Bok or sewing kit?
Bok Bok.
Okay.
She can hear you.
Now, who do you want to pick as your partner? Ask her.
I'm going to go with JC. Okay. Right there.
Yeah, okay. Good choice.
Okay. So Bok Bok, this is different chicken places and different ways to eat chicken, because it's National Chicken Month.
Okay,
hold on a second here. Let me... Yeah, you hold the phone up to me. Okay, thank you, because I got to load up the sound effects and everything. All right, we're going to have 60 seconds on the clock. You get six correct, and you win.
Awesome.
You got to hold her up. I can do it. She's got to stay closer to the microphone.
Okay.
All right, hold on a second. I'm loading up our Heads Up thing here. Okay, 60 seconds on the clock, and we start now. This place has a brand-new chicken sandwich. It just sold out. He's also a cartoon character. Popeyes is correct. This is a style of chicken, long form.
Chicken fingers?
No, Las Vegas Boulevard is called the what?
Strip.
Yes. Correct. This chicken place is not open on Sundays, but a great chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A.
Yes. This style of chicken, you put it in the oven. You would also do this to cookies. You would do what to it?
Baked.
Yeah, baked chicken. Nice. Correct. No, baked chicken.
Okay.
This Colonel. The Colonel has his chicken. What's the name of the place?
Kentucky Fried Chicken?
Yes. We'll skip this one. B-Dubs is a chicken place here in town.
What is it?
B-Dubs?
B-Dubs. I don't know. Pass.
Okay, passing that one. This is a style of eating chicken. It would be between bread. It would be a what? A chicken what?
Chicken sandwich.
Yes, and then you...
That's six.
That's six?
That's six.
Yeah! Yes! We did it!
Ivy! Questionable and some this chicken.
Well, chickens can be in the name of everything, right? You know?
I think just for you getting on the phone with us and the fact that you have JC's cell phone number, you are a winner in every way. Congratulations.
I'll keep it a secret, JC, I promise.
If you need anything, just give me a call.
JC's all send nudes.
Mercedes. All right, Tara, you just got a $250 promo card to Living Spaces. Congratulations.
Awesome. Thank you.
Oh, we're gonna text you all the time now. You're awesome. Thank you so much.
All right, hold, here's Steph. Steph has my phone. She can get your information. All right, so there we go.
And now I wonder if we're gonna do it with this wave for Secret Sound. We'll see.
All right.
It's time for the Mercedes Hot 3, Mix 94.1.
And the Hot 3 is brought to you by College of Southern Nevada, now enrolling for fall semester.
All right, so the teachers union reached a deal with the Clark County School District after weeks of negotiation over teacher contracts. The deal comes as members of the union, the Clark County Education Association, had been preparing to strike. On September 10th, at a press conference yesterday, the CCESD Board of Trustees president said that it had been a tense few weeks, but they were happy to announce that this strike had been averted. They say the long-term financial stability of the district, though, requires us to continue their laser-sharp focus on increasing funding at the state level and implementing new funding formulas. So some of the things that are happening now, that 3% adjustment for every employee in the beginning unit with an adjustment on the current salary schedule is happening. They're going to have a 4% increase in both years in CCSD's contribution to monthly health insurance premiums. And then that professional growth system with the reimbursement, if you are trying to get more education under their watch, you will be reimbursed from that, from what I understand.
That's awesome.
So, yeah, good news on that.
Do you remember when we were very young when it happened? The NFL, they had a strike in the 80s.
No.
And the players were striking, and it went like 3 or 4 weeks with no games. And then finally, some players started crossing the picket line. And then they started getting, I don't know if they made a rule or not, but they started getting what they called scab players.
I've heard of scabs before. Those are the people that go in and take the place.
Yes,
while
exactly. Okay. So the scab players, I remember watching games and the announcers being like, Tom, the wide receiver last week was driving a dump truck, and now he's the wide receiver for the Dallas. Ooh. And they were bringing in people that were not qualified to be playing football.
Wait,
it was awesome.
So they just grabbed random people off the street to play football?
People were coming in. I think you had to try out, but it was some guy. Yeah, I played high school ball 10 years ago. I still got it, and they were putting people out there. And then NFL players started to come back. Because I remember Tony Dorsett was the running back for the Cowboys. And he's like, okay, if you got, you know, Tom, the truck driver, as the lineman, I'm going to come back and play. And he was running all over these guys.
Oh, my gosh. That would be the way to go. You set all these records and get stats and get bonuses.
Yes,
because you set
records. Yeah, because you played against the scabs.
Like, bring on the scabs. Come on. A recent BuzzFeed poll looked at how good we are at adulting. Isn't it? Did you tell me you hate that phrase when people say, like, we're adulting now?
We had a conversation about that. Yeah, that's just we're adults.
Yeah.
What was the class it was? It was the adulting class.
Yes, up in Northern California, yeah. They have an adulting class. Well, they listed a bunch of things you should know how to do as an adult, and they asked readers whether or not they can do them. So let's see if you're better at adulting than most people, okay? Can you swallow a pill fairly easily? Yes, 91% of people say they can. Can you neatly wrap a gift?
At times, yes.
Yeah, what's your definition of neatly? It's presentable,
mm-hmm.
But don't examine the corners because I'm really taping stuff together there. Do you know how to write a check?
Yes.
76% say they know how, which isn't bad, but 20 years ago, it would have been 100%, don't you think?
I think that's kind of low. I think I would assume 99% of adults know how to write a check.
I thought so too. Huh. Could you sew a button back on?
Yes.
I can. I do. I sew buttons. That's pretty much all I can sew. 73% of people say they can do it. Can you fold a fitted sheet? No one can.
It's not foldable.
You have to just scrunch it up in a ball and try to make it look like it was folded. 61% of people say they can. Can you kill a spider without screaming?
Yes.
59% said yes to that. And can you change a flat tire?
Yes. You?
That was the first thing my dad taught me how to do when I learned how to drive. However, knock on wood, I've never had to be put in that situation. And if I did, I'm not 100% I would remember how to do it. It's been a while.
I would now, because of you, I now have AAA.
Yeah,
I would
just
use
call
my AAA. Hey, come on out.
All right. Finally, this morning, want to win a lifetime supply of mac and cheese? Of course you do. Want to go swimming in a giant bowl of mac and cheese? Maybe. Boston Market just launched a new rewards program. Now, we used to have them here, but they're not here anymore. I don't know what happened to Boston Market in Las Vegas, but to kick things off for their new rewards program, they're giving out a sweet prize to the first person to get 10,000 points. They will win 1 ton of any side dish. So that could be mac and cheese. It could be mashed potatoes, creamed spinach, anything else Boston Market offers. And they're totally flexible with how you'll get your 2,000 pounds of food. If you want to divide it up so you get a portion every day for decades, that's fine. If you want it all in one giant bowl, they say, quote, we'll deliver via a one-ton freight. To get 10,000 points, someone will have to spend $10,000. Man, it would be rough to be the person who spends $10,000 at Boston Market and find out someone else did it first. And then
you
got
beat
that
you to it. Oh, I'm at 9,900. You beat me.
Oh, man. So if you're interested, you're going to have to go to another market to get your Boston Market. But still, it's something worth looking at. If maybe you have family in another part of the country, let them know, because that's kind of cool.
That's a good restaurant. I completely blocked that out until you brought that up. That's a great restaurant.
That was like rotisserie chicken, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good stuff. I remember they had one at Sahara and Fort Apache, and I would always get the rotisserie
it's
chicken
good
there.
Eating
so
right
good.
There.
Yeah. So you were telling us earlier that you're on a diet / like body, mind, soul / like, what is it? Slim and Sexy 95 or something like that. What you call it? What's it called?
It's called 75 Hard.
Oh,
it is a mind.
That sounds interesting.
Mind, body, and soul transformation. And it's a guy by the name of Andy Frisella is his name. He's an entrepreneur. He is in the supplement business is his main business. He's a podcaster. And he does this program called 75 Hard. And I've heard him talk about it and do it before. And he finished it, and now he's just restarting it. So he's asking people that follow him, if you want to do it, I'm doing it again now. So I decided to do this 75 Hard program. And I started it 2 days ago. There's a lot of things that go into it.
So wait, 75 days?
75 days straight.
What's the hard part?
It's the whole thing itself is hard.
This is really hard?
So first, I kind of made some tweaks to it.
I like the three easy one. That's mine. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm tweaking a little bit, so maybe it's like 75 medium to hard for me.
But then you're not truly doing it. What's so hard about it?
Well, the first thing is work out twice a day for 45 minutes each session.
Are you doing that?
And one of those workouts has to be outside in the elements. So if you normally go to the gym, you got to work out in the morning outside. One of your workouts needs to be outside. So, no, I'm not doing that. But I am doing modified two workouts a day because I normally don't work out every day. So for the next 75 days, I need to work out every day and also twice a day. So what I'm doing is first thing in the morning is I'm getting up and I'm doing some push-ups every morning.
Okay.
So that's my first workout.
How long do you do that for? 45 minutes?
No, 25 push-ups.
Oh, so 1 minute.
Yeah.
Okay.
But then I'm making myself go work out in the afternoon every day. So for the next 75 days, I gotta work out. You have to drink a gallon of water a day.
Oh, man. For someone who goes to the bathroom as much as you do, that's going to just, whoa.
So that I did for the first 2 days. I did my gallon each day. You need to read 10 pages of like a self-help motivational type book every day. So I'm doing that as well. 10 pages every day. You need to, I won't show you, but you need to take a progress picture every day. So that I'm doing as well.
I want to see it. Hi. I love when JC takes his selfies. Is it a selfie?
Yeah. I'm not.
Let me
see
it. You don't have to let me look at it close up. Just a little flash it so I can kind of get an idea.
I'm in the bathroom.
This morning.
Yeah. First thing in the morning.
Okay. Wow. Look at you. Man.
This morning at 3:11 a.m., that was my picture.
This is my imitation of you. JC's tilting his head to the side, like trying to give a little like sexy eye, like, this is real. This is me. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be.
But this
what song is that? This is real. This is me.
This whole thing, it forces you to do stuff that you're not that you normally might push off, another day. Like, I'll go to the gym tomorrow. I won't work out today. It kind of gets you out of your comfort zone. And there's a couple more layers that go into it. I'm just kind of taking this whole thing for on the surface. It's also, you need to stick to a diet, whatever diet that is for you, that works best for you. So there's a couple little things that I'm tweaking in my diet that I've stuck to the first 2 days. Like, I like to eat rice cakes with honey. That's like my thing. I eat it all day long. And so I'm removing the honey, and I'm just snacking on rice cakes throughout the day.
I mean, this is great. And I'm just poking fun at you.
I know
because
you are.
I think it's great whenever you want to improve yourself and just be a better person physically, mentally. I think that's fantastic. And if this is the thing, even if it's a modified version, because it does sound like it's very hard to go into this 100%. You have to be very disciplined and you have to have a schedule that allows it. And I totally get that you are making baby steps to get to that. So that's awesome. I really commend you for that.
And there's days too where I just like, there's a couple days coming up in the next couple weeks. I'm like, how am I going to work out? Just some kind of gym workout. And that's going to be the struggle, is that those are the days I got to make it work somehow. And I can work out at home and stuff, but so it's called 75 Hard. I started it 2 days ago and you get a little thing to kind of like, so they give a little thing to kind of mark off your days.
Oh, cool. Are you marking them off?
Yeah, I got to mark off. I'm on day three, so I got to go mark off day two.
Even though it's more like, you know, five easy.
75 hard-ish. You know, just going back to the picture you have to take every day of yourself. Yeah. So that's like, there's the picture, okay? Yesterday, someone was going to airdrop me some photos, so I got my phone to open up to make sure an airdrop.
Yeah.
And this is the picture they see. They're standing next to me. They look at my phone. I'm like, oh!
Oh, man. Who is this self-absorbed jerk taking topless selfies in his mirror with his head turned slightly, looking like, hey. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that out loud? No, I'm just kidding. You're trying to improve yourself.
I'm trying.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So, I feel like you're always working on yourself as well and trying to make yourself a better person. You're always doing that.
I try. You know, it's a struggle for real, though, and you know, so someone said something to me that made me kind of open my eyes on just how I'm perceived. And so I'm really trying harder to not, you know, portray myself as like a victim and feeling sorry for myself. So I'm just trying to do better on that and analyze my words before they come out of my mouth. And in the process, I had a friend say, like, you seem more reserved. You don't seem like as forthcoming the other day. And it was like, I feel torn. I'm trying to edit myself more these days. And in the process, I know I'm not being my true self, but I'm trying. I am trying to be better. It's just, you can't only be better for you. You can't try to be better for other people. That's what the bottom line I've learned.
Mm-hmm.
You can change yourself so to try to make other people like you better. But at the end of the day, if you don't like yourself and how you're being, it doesn't really matter. So I'm being more accepting of people not liking me. It's like, I don't care. I'm happy. That's all I care about.
Have you heard of, I think his name is it Gary V? Have you heard of this Gary V guy? He's like an Instagram influencer, like motivational guy.
I've heard of Gary D. Bababooey.
Gary V. He's an interesting follow on Instagram. And then also the other one that I'm still listening to, his podcast, that Ed Milet guy and Max Out Your Life. That guy, his podcast is life-changing. Life-changing, I tell you.
You know what else is life-changing?
What?
Camp Rock. Did you put that song in there, Steph? You know what I was singing when I was saying, this is real, this is me, this is exactly where I'm supposed to be?
Yes.
That was from Camp Rock.
This is real, this is me, I'm exactly
where I'm supposed to be.
So wait, I'm doing this. I'm doing the 75 Hard program, and you're doing the Camp Rock, this is me lifestyle.
I'm doing the Camp Rock self-analysis workout. This is me.
Do you have to take a picture of yourself every day?
No, you just have to lip sync to Demi Lovato. That's all you got to do.
All right, I got to use the bathroom.
Mercedes in the Mornings, what's trending on Mix 94.1.
Okay, binge drinking is trending this morning. A new study says calories from binge drinking can be the equivalent to eating a double cheeseburger. Having four or five drinks on one occasion is somewhere around 550 calories or more. And on average, drinkers ingest 250 calories from alcohol per day, which is the same as eating like a bag of chips. But this study also showed that 52.5% of drinkers get their calories from beer. 21% get their calories from wine. 20% from spirits and 6.5% from ciders and coolers.
You know, I'm doing that, talked about last hour, that 75 Hard program here for the mind, body, and spirit for the next 75 days. One of the things of the program is no alcohol, no alcohol for 75 days.
So are you
going to
do it?
No, I'm still going to have, because I don't drink that much. I have a glass of wine or a cocktail on the weekend, and so I'm going to still continue that. Again,
you're not really doing this program. You're inventing your own program because you're changing everything. Call it JC 30. It's not the same program.
It's 75 medium to hardish is what I'm doing. Okay, but that's like no alcohol for 75 days.
You should try it. Let's, because I mean, I know you could give it up. It's just, I know sometimes you like a glass of wine.
Yeah, exactly. So don't take that away from me.
I won't. It might make you feel worse. And but then what's the point of doing this whole program?
That's right. It doesn't help my mind, body, or soul. Alcohol does.
All right. Also trending this morning is Matthew McConaughey. He has been co-teaching a class called Script to Screen since 2015. But now he will become a full-on instructor at the University of Texas at Austin. That means he can mentor students, explore teaching other classes, and participate in all of the university events. Of course, it doesn't mean he's going to be there for every single class. I know a lot of people are like, oh, okay, I'll sign up. But the school says the frequency that he will attend the script-to-screen class this fall all depends on his schedule.
All right, all right, all right.
Wouldn't that be nice if you're like, yeah, I'll take the job, but I'll show up when it works with my schedule.
How does that work?
Sorry, I can't come in today. It doesn't work with my schedule. I got stuff going on. My bad.
No, we've worked with people like that before.
Yeah,
though.
We certainly have. Also trending this morning is TSA. So the TSA has banned thermal detonator Coca-Cola bottles from the new Star Wars themed lands at Disneyland and Disney World. The exclusive item, which is sold only at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, resembles an explosive-like device seen in Return of the Jedi. Now, TSA is banning the containers as they closely resemble a dangerous weapon, calling them a replica of an explosive. That means not only can you not put it in your carry-on baggage, but you can't put it in your checked-in baggage either. It's completely banned on this one. So,
You still can't check it.
That's what the story says.
Wow.
That you can't check it in.
It looks like a grenade.
Yeah. So can't just be putting grenades in your bag. But
that's a great souvenir, though. That's good to know. You can't bring it home.
I guess you're gonna have to hit the road, drive it home if you want. Maybe someone can set up a business where you transport those directly to their home via your vehicle. You pay a certain amount for shipping, or maybe FedEx it to your house. Why not?
You absolutely could.
Yeah. All right. And that's what's trending.
Or like the guy in town who used to be the IKEA guy. He would drive to IKEA in California and buy the stuff you want, and he would deliver it to your house here in Vegas.
Yes.
And then IKEA opened up here in town, and well, his business, I'm sure, is not as profitable.
Wasn't there a Chick-fil-A person too that would bring back sandwiches from Chick-fil-A in Utah? And now we have them here, so they're all out of work.
Oh,
maybe
man.
This will be their new
Mercedes in the morning.
And that is it for us on a Thursday. Thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for sitting through some of our technical difficulties, but I think things are all worked out. We only have a meeting with our boss now after the show because we're in trouble.
Text us this. Take a guess as why we have to have a meeting with our boss about today's show.
Yeah, 702-364-9400. You can text us right there. But that's it for us. We'll be back tomorrow, Friday. It's going to be a fun show. We have the Friday Rewind, of course, happening in the 9 o'clock hour. The Oh Wow Wheel happening just after 8 o'clock. And, of course, more tickets for you, VIP style, for you to see the